to our broadcast. Today, we're going to talk about cell phones, what they are, where they've come, and specifically how they affect the classroom in today's middle and high schools across America. Several years ago, in 2003, there was a study done and showed that 1.2 billion people in the world own a cell phone. Now, that's 4 years ago. Just imagine what the number is today. Probably well over 2 billion people, one out of every three people who walk the earth owns a cell phone. That's kind of crazy. A cell phone is a portable cordless communication device that receives and delivers communication. Well, here's a good example. You can open it up. Some of them don't open, but this one does. You can dial a number. You can hit send, and magically someone on the other end picks up and talks to you. But these have been around for a long time, right? Well, cell phones, unlike regular telephones, you can take basically anywhere. I can carry it in my pocket, travel across the country, and still get a call from someone. Other phones that tend to fall a little outside my price range are referred to as smartphones. Probably the most popular one is the iPhone. And these phones are able to do much more than just send and receive calls and text messages. They basically are miniature computers, and many of them can even access the internet from basically anywhere you can make a phone call. So you're probably asking yourself, okay, we know what a cell phone is, we have one, we know how to use it. What's this have to do with education? Well, that's a great question, and that's really the reason we're even looking at this topic today. Many classrooms across the country are constantly interrupted by cell phones. The fact is, these cell phones have become major distractions, and the initial reaction of schools across the country, and I think rightly so, let's just say, no cell phones in school. These things are just distractions. We don't need them. Just either don't, many schools said don't bring them. Some said if you have them, turn them off, put them in your book bag. But the common policy basically across the board was no cell phones in schools. Oftentimes, students leave their ringers on, get phone calls, it disrupts class. Many students just text way too much, and they can't even stop for 45 minutes, to sit through a class without texting. Students that have these smartphones are able to check the internet, go on Facebook, you name it. They can sit there, they can be watching DVDs in class while the teacher is trying to teach. And this is just not the best thing. Not too long ago, there was a study done by ACECOM among parents of students. And let me read you some of the findings real quick. I think they're pretty interesting and definitely pertain to what we're talking about here today. 95% of the parents who were surveyed said they think that they should control their student's cell phone and not the school. So basically, they don't agree with the school setting regulations on students having their cell phones or not. 99% want their students to be able to call them if danger arises, which makes sense. 84% of parents want to have open contact with their children via phone. This is whether there's an incident that occurs or not. They just want to be able to contact their child. 71% said they think their children need a cell phone because administrators will not allow them to use the school phones. So clearly, it's not a cut and dry issue. There's reasons that phones should not be in the school, and there's reasons, on the other hand, that they should be, or at least that the parents think they should be. Let's take a turn here and look at ways the phone can be used to actually enhance education in the classroom. So really now, let's be honest, how can you use a cell phone to enhance education? Well, there's really lots of ways. One thing is, a lot of classrooms are short on technology. Maybe they have a couple computers, maybe some digital cameras, video cameras. Well, if students have their cell phones, many of their cell phones are able to do these things that the cameras and the computers can do, but the classrooms don't have enough, so they can use their own technology kind of as a supplement to incorporate more of the classroom and have less people on the outside just watching what's going on. Another thing is, just as an example, if you were a lot of times in an English class, you might be teaching students how to do the application and interview process. You could have a student actually call in on a cell phone and interview right there in class and have other students listen, and afterwards you can have a discussion and talk about what went well, what didn't do well, and this could all be made possible because they have their cell phone right there. One more technology that exists today but is not very prevalent is called the Twitter. And basically what Twittering is it's kind of like an incorporation of text messaging and Blackboard, because a teacher could text maybe an assignment or just a thought or some advice for studying to students, and they would all immediately receive what she sent out. And the thing is, they can choose whether they want to receive it maybe on their PDA, on their cell phone, on their email. So basically, this allows the gap between the teacher and the student to decrease and allows their communication just to be much more than it was before. Just an example, imagine there's a student, coming home from school, and he's got a big test tomorrow, drives home, he's getting ready to start studying, all of a sudden, gets a text message, looks at his phone, and his teacher has just Twittered that she forgot to mention, that this one more section of essays was going to be on the test, so just be sure you study. Where before, if she had sent out an email or a Blackboard message, he might not check his email until 8 o'clock that night, and by that point he thinks he's done, thinks he's ready for the test, and can be really frustrated. So in that sense, just speeding up the communication can be really effective. So Twittering seems all fine and dandy, but what are some of the downsides? Well, on one front, this obviously depends that everyone has means to at least a computer or a cell phone with text messaging or something of that device. And in many schools today, that's not the case. Maybe down the road, it'll become so common that it's just like owning a pair of shoes, everyone will have one. But right now, at least in many parts of the country, that's not the case. And secondly, in some universities where this has already been incorporated, many people just don't like the, just a lack of privacy, and say they feel like it's just too much. Like anybody can contact them just like that so fast. Like anybody in their class or the professors, anytime they want, they almost can't get away from it. They say it's, too technologically noisy. So maybe we'll see Twittering down the road incorporated into the classrooms, and maybe we won't. So what does the future hold? Who knows how we will be using our cell phones down the road, and even more, how we'll be using them in the classroom. Maybe Twittering will take off. Maybe it's some technology that we don't even know of yet. It's my belief that technology is going to improve education down the road and make our lives better as teachers and as students. So hopefully that will be the case. Until next time, I'm Ken Gibbons. Happy talking. Hey, John. Yeah, I'm just finishing up, actually.
I hear the drums echoing tonight, and she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation.
She's coming in. One more really cool thing that a cell phone can do is cell phones are gonna be made available. Maybe it's my belief that students and teachers can have that communication gap shortened even more. Communication gap shortened even more, and they're just able to just communicate quicker and be more efficient as far as that goes. So basically, students and teachers are able to communicate easily. And kind of shorten that communication. One out of every five persons. In that sense, just speeding up the communication is really, really, really exciting. So Twittering seems all fine and grand, but what are some of the downsides? Well, to just talk really quickly, really more than,
I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like.
So really, how can a cell phone actually enhance education in the classroom? Well, another thing is,